With the guilty verdicts in the Rajaratnam case, we take a look at the likely appeal process. And joining me now to help sort that out is Tom Dewey, co-founder of the law firm Dewey, Pegno, and Kramarsky. He is a commercial litigator whose practice emphasizes securities, international, and intellectual property matters. We were just talking about the appeal process here during the commercial break, Tom. On what basis is he going to appeal at this point?
Lisa, I think the main focus of his appeal is going to be that the judge should not have let in all of the wiretaps that proved to be such devastating evidence against Mr. Rajaratnam. I think that is really where the defense is going to focus on this appeal.
Why not use the wiretaps? We've been talking about that being critical to this case as something that we haven't seen in prior cases of this nature. Why is that such, I don't want to call it a big deal, but why was that so sort of precedent setting?
Well, as you say, this was the first time the government had made very widespread use of wiretaps in a sort of white-collar insider trading case. I think that the focus of the defense is going to be the government should not have been permitted to play these at trial because the search warrant that allowed the government to grab this evidence didn't permit the tapes to be admitted. That was the focus of their argument before Judge Holwell, who was the trial court judge, and that will be the key thing they'll argue on appeal.
Well, there are more defendants, right? There are more trials coming up related to Galleon Group. How are these people going to find an unbiased jury at this point?
I think it will be difficult, but I'm a person that has a lot of confidence in the jury system, and I think that jurors will be able to weigh the evidence against each individual defendant, defendant by defendant. And I think there are systems in place that will try and ensure, and I think will ensure, that those defendants get a fair trial.
Anything the defense could have done differently in this case?
Lisa, I think they had a very tough hand to play. The combination of the wiretap evidence and all the evidence from the cooperating witnesses together made it very, very difficult for Mr. Rajaratnam to beat this case.
Now, let's talk about Michael Kimmelman. He was an employee of Galleon.
Yeah.
Interesting defense strategy. He said he could have cut a plea deal and gotten out of this situation, but he didn't. And that's something they want to allow into evidence. Does that make any sense to you?
That'll be a real challenge. That is, as you say, a novel defense, and I doubt it's one that the jury's going to be hearing about in his case.
What do you think is going to happen with the expert networks at this point? There's been a big gray area as to what exactly insider trading is in terms of the way they do their research.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to be a lot more rigorous in the way things go. I think that's already happened as a result of this prosecution, and I think things will tighten up further.